third position, which is where he finished in the last tournament in the Bahamas. So I'm not familiar with the rules of beach soccer. It's a game of three thirds, not two halves. So we have a toss of the coin now before the final period. Period's 12 minutes each. You've got two referees who'll be on the sand officiating. All free kicks are direct and also unopposed. Fine job, the Iranian coach. Keep the team into the world's top 10. Definitely competing with the top European sides. And a chance for them to prove it tonight if they can. Beat the likes of Italy. It will just show again they've taken an extra step and maybe have some way to make up for the disappointment of not qualifying for the World Cup. Japan and UAE from Asia. Making their way to Paraguay. So Italy will kick off, all in blue, Gordy. Well out of play. Hamid in goal again. Hosseini, who was the most valuable goalkeeper at the 2017 World Cup, has barely had a look in this tournament. Well, he will get a look in later in this game, we'll see. Contingent of Iranian fans you can see on the far side. Pretty noisy as well, got their flags out. You can imagine a lot of people in Qatar are Iranian, just across the water here. A lot of expats. Yeah, it goes wide. Shot takes the bounce off the sand. No mess, you can watch it wide. Mikioti, chest control, not such a good pass. See what he's trying to do, he's trying to lift it towards Gordy so he can get the overhead kick in. Hamid. Sumi. Not a bad effort at all. Well done, Mesty. Waved it wide, but I'm not sure who got there. Gianni did really well. Gordy, first overhead from him, straight into the grateful arms of Hamid. Okay. He's just warming up there. 11 goals and some return, isn't it? Three games, group stage and then one semi-final. Final game for him today, of course, in this bronze medal match. Basketball style picks it up. Amakioti does well to get it across. Gordy looks to try and flick it up, and the Iranians know that and are running very, very quickly. And there is the first goal. It's from Iran. It's on the break. Assumi with it. Strikes through the ball. Just the power to beat the goalkeeper, even though he gets his hand to it. Contingent of Iranian fans, very happy. In fact, it's the sand that gives it a slight deflection away from the goalkeeper. I don't think he was anywhere near that. El Mestri maybe slightly out of position, a step or two. More to his left would have been better. As it stands though, the records will only show one thing, and that is an Iranian goal. Iran 1, Italy 0. Man like Chibaro, Rosetta, and the goal scorer. Well, that's interesting. He did touch him, but whether he intended to or what he was trying to do, I'm not sure. I think we've got a fair idea of where he got hit there. Let's watch again. He pushed him away and caught him in the midriff, shall we say. I think everything's in intact. Assuming back on his feet, he was the most valuable player in the Iranian league last year. You've got to be careful with it. Good save from Hamid. Giovaro did well, She didn't have much time to turn and to improvise slightly. Gentle to his goal. Unusual technique for the goalkeeper there. He's spun round looking at his goal rather than turning and going side on. Assuming the goal scorer is pretty involved in everything at the moment. Del Mesti. Slightly by a shot. Maronai. Just got a nice shot and Hamid behind it holds on to it really well. And you can see why he's played most of the minutes. Played running goal. Over in Hosseini. Very lucky around it. Got Hamid, who won most valuable goalkeeper at the Asian Championship, and then Hosseini, the other goalkeeper, won most valuable player at the last World Cup in 2017. Free kick going around. Right thing. So two techniques really from that distance. Either go for power or try and bounce it in front of the goalkeeper. A couple of meters from him ideally. Does that. Del Mestri gets the beard behind it, I think. Full in the face. Don't think that beard provided enough padding. He's asking for the physio to come on. Full in the face. He was going the right way and then that bounce just lifts it up into his face. Bounces off his arm before. Now the magic water bottle's been out and he's fixed. He misses his touch. Doesn't have to deal with the corner, which will be a relief to him. Hamid. Ali, back to Hamid. Chance over the top. He's changed his shirt recently and put his full name on it. Previously the youngest player out there today, he's 22, just had Ali on his shirt. No, stick with that. Can't let you. Well, the commentator's dream if every player had a 3 or 4 letter name. Domestic. Corner to Italy. Fiannetti, World Cup veteran, to take it. Bari hooks it away. He's been excellent for Iran throughout the tournament. I'd say their standout player, both defensively and in attack. Cirlo. He looks kind of like Gabriel Gori. He plays similar as well. Goalkeeper. Brody, just open on his foot and probably a little bit too much as it goes wide. So watch that overhead kick from Zilla once again. Vanetti has taken a shot full to the head. Well, the beach soccer ball apparently is 200 grams lighter than a normal football, but it hits you at that pace, it still hurts. Del Mestri wasn't particularly fast header, too much power on it, so it was reasonably easy for Del Mestri to deal with. Sumi. Wheelchair, not given. Tony thinks about the overhead. Now Q's up for one. Oh, what a finish that is! Absolutely fantastic. No chance with Del Mestri in goal. But he thought about it as the ball flew over for the cross. He thought twice, controlled it, flicked it up, and queued it up absolutely perfectly. Most valuable player at the Asian Cup in 2017 shows us why. Seventh goal for him in the tournament. Lucky seventh for Iran. Del Mestri quite rightly there, says maybe his defenders could have got closer. They didn't. So it is Iran 2, Italy 0. They'd rather go away with that. Del Mestri gratefully receives it. Gordy. Ricky Elsie can't control it. So around, possession back to their goalkeeper. Back to his goalkeeper again. Goal scorer, Sumi. Horn on the far side. A fan dressed in a shirt made of Iranian flags. It could be the look of winter 2019. Have to be careful, eh? He was pulling and tugging at Iranian shirts, but the referee didn't see anything untoward. Glory. 2 to the foul. It's a little nudge, wasn't it, as he tried to turn for the ball. Bronze medal match here at the A&L World Beach Games. Still to go, we have the gold medal match in the women's event. Follow that with the men's gold medal match, Russia against Italy. Sorry, Russia against Brazil. Italy are here now. Chiavaro, that's his goalkeeper. Del Mestri, Chiavaro. Del Mestri, game of beach foot tennis here. Chelsea does well, springs so high in the air, can't find a blue shirt, so chance for the round to break. Hardy. Good run, but eventually loses out possession. Chelsea, Ahmed. Does well, he's brave. It's just wide. Tsumi with it. Not sure too much going forward here, Italy. Zerlo. Chivaro. Here the shout from Del Maestri. Ball back. For once uses his feet rather than hands. And he should stick with the hands. Tsumi already one goal in this game. Or previously. Machi. Zerlo. Oh, Hamid was off his line so quickly. And again, it's the mid-drift. Well, for a beach soccer player, when you're playing at such close quarters with your opponents, that happens a lot. He's gone out with that K-shape as a goalkeeper. It's popular now in the 11-a-side game as well. Comes with his problems. You expose certain parts of your body. There you go, there's the man and his shirt made of Iranian flags. No foul given. Palmacci moving forward. The best ball in the world. They're a very static Italy waiting for it at the far end. Palmacci. Oh, that was a great effort. He kind of dug it out of the sand and just got that curl on it. And everybody was watching it, including Hamid, but the post saved him. Zerlo. He really dug it out well from the sand. Into the final minute. Great effort from Palmacci, wasn't it? Brilliant. It's the fact he turned, he got the curl on it and won. Zerlo, in the meantime, we admire Palmacci's shot, we could admire Zerlo's overhead kick. Sadly, though, it was a half meter the wrong side of the post. There's no time limit on a goalkeeper when it's at his feet. If it's in his hands, he's got 5 seconds to play it out. Same on corners, same on throw-ins and kick-ins. Can't really waste time in beach soccer. So there is the hooter for the end of the first period. It is a good one for Iran. Otari Atsumi with the goals. As we watch the final shot of the period, it would have been an Iran corner if there was time. There wasn't, but they won't mind too much because they lead at the break. Iran 2, Italy 0.
Once again, special reminder to all the fans here at Beach Locker Arena, this is a strictly non-smoking zone.
Capito? Forza!
Okay, where are the kids? Did I see some kids? Kids in attendance? I want to see kids, and come on, let's find who's the best dancer. Oh, where you at? I want to get a kiss. Oh, come on! Let me see you dance, come on!
Good contingent of Iranian fans here, and they are very pleased with the scoreline as it stands. Look at the stats on that first period. Iran at 14 shots, 6 of them on target, and Italy just 6 shots with 3 on target. So you can see the difference. Iran have definitely been on the front foot in this game, goalkeeper wise. Italy's goalkeepers had to make 4 saves, but Iran just the 2. And Italy have switched the goalkeeper to give Dalmestri a rest. Peter is in, doesn't have to deal with anything there. Hamid remains in goal for Iran. Substitutions in beach soccer, if you're unfamiliar with the sport, they are continuous from rolling. Gordy looks for the corner, gets the corner, signals with 2 fingers on the far side, Marinai, which will mean something to the Italian players. I get a feeling you always do 2 fingers, it's going far post. See? I was right. It's not much of a code then, is it? I can work it out. One finger or one arm, near post, 2, far post. To me, strike, and not Peter grasps it, the second attempt. Marchiotti, he's normally better than that. A player who plays speech soccer in the Italian and Russian league, the championship sides. Really good player, really unusual for beach soccer. He's so tall, yet so effective, and can score lots of goals. The added advantage of that height is perfect for headers, setting it up across the box. It hasn't happened as yet, though. Assuming. Goal scorer 5 in the tournament. Very, very lively today. To use a footballing cliche. We can't use as a game of 2 halves. It's 3:30 in the beach soccer, 12 minutes each. Played a minute and a half the second period. Very unlike Rami Kotti, he's a very, very good player, great close control. And to miss the volley and then miscontrol it out of play there is definitely not like him. These little indications sometimes, not either. It might not be a team's night, and it's when things like that happen. When players who are so consistent normally make a few mistakes, makes you think things aren't firing for the Italians at the moment. Peter. No. Giovanni. Some cards to give away. I don't think there's anyone who can act innocent better than the Italians. It barely works. I don't think you can play too much. There's the innocent look. Me? Could have possibly been fouled somebody. Dare you suggest such a thing? No, Peter's gone clean shaven tonight. Strike, the bounce. easy for now Beavis Carpita to deal with. Scored against Iran in the World Cup a couple of years ago. And Gordy did, as he plays on the sand at the moment. He did some damage against Iran in that World Cup. Well, he could do with reenacting that right now. This game has no peace about it at all. Shot was hopeful rather than anything else. Who last met, it was a victory for Italy, 5-4. Right. Chance not being around to break, held up though by Gurry, doing defensive duties for once. Well, he was clever there, just threw it onto the back of his opponent, and the referee spoiled the fun there. To turn your back on somebody throwing the ball, it's your own fault. Should be, I don't think that should have been retaken. What was wrong with that? As a defender, you should never turn your back on a thrower. Well, we don't make our pizza. Good chest control and a good shot. He did well, didn't he? Because he was facing one way and managed to twist his body with the chest control and get the volley away. Magic. Peter by Magic. Maybe he'd have fancied a turn there. He could have gotten down the line. Past the post, not far away at all. Here with the effort. There's that disjointed approach from Italy once again. Any great full details of what's going on this evening here at the ANOC World Beach Games. This is the bronze medal playoff match. At the moment, looks like Iran could be on the podium. As Italy can switch things around, they've not shown anything as yet. Their shots and shots on target ratio in the first half is pretty poor. 6 shots and just 3 on target. This half, neither team got their metaphorical shooting boots on. The shot's just wide. Things that are very easy for the goalkeeper to deal with. And Chiotti. It looked good, didn't it, for a second, and then the delicate ball over the top was just had too much on it for his teammates who were all heading towards him. Iran have to go backwards to go forwards. Forwards in space and time. Again, it's wayward. Ali will be disappointed with that. Mostly inventive a chance, but it does the job. Chelsea's lost it. Ali over the top. Second round. Gordy. Very nice. There's the gap of the shot. He's scrambling to pick it up. Well, if anyone's going to win a free kick in that situation, it's that man. And what a position it is for him. Central. Around about a metre and a half outside of the area. McFarley was the man who committed the foul, but you've got to be so careful with that man. He will make the most of it, as he did there. Magic spray on his behind. He's done the trick, he's back on his feet. Coach Ruran, he's played professional football. Sent out in the first division. Now Duca, coach of an Italian club, beach soccer. Successful there with Telecina, winning Scudettos and Cups. Promotion to the national team. Gordy takes his time. He's flattening out the sand. Oh, that's a very good save by Hamid. He really caught that, Gordy. Saved by Hamid again. Gets a kick for his troubles on the rebound. Lucchiotti apologises. Watch that save again from Hamid. He needed to put it a little bit lower, didn't he, Gori? It's rather easy to tell where it was going as well, the way he shaped his body. We're not worrying about it too much, Iran, because their goalkeeper, spare goalkeeper, I've seen, he's just sat on the bench. He's not moved to warm up in any way, shape or form. That's say it again for the free kick. It's outstanding saves in this tournament, Hamid. It's going to be difficult to score from this position. He may go for one side or another just to roll the ball. See if one of his teammates can pick it up. Striking, he's done just that. Got to get it away. Another wayward overhead kick. Mokhtari, hat-trick of wayward overhead kicks for Iran. Stadium pretty full here. We've got good attendance at the beach soccer. The ANOC World Beach Games. Which is pretty good because there's no home team playing, but when you consider the number of expats that live in Qatar, then there's always been fans of every single country. Even El Salvador had about 10-15 fans here. Of course, there's Italians here, but the vast majority of the fans here are Iranian. They'll be very happy with the scoreline as it stands. Maranai with a free kick. Save by Hamid Gordy, finally! Well, if Italy are playing, then Gordy's scoring. That's just what he's done. Not his most spectacular goals, but it's opened the door for Italy. Ricocheted off the goalkeeper's knee, couldn't get out of the way quick enough. Gorey. There's Gorey on the spot. Cool finish. Must be watching those relays. Gorey has gone off. Seems to have hurt himself. Went down on his knees after the goal. May have pulled something. Remember, he was out for 2 months before this tournament with injury. And saved by Gothita. Vital save. And the post saves him that time. Well, it's blowing this game if Gorey is out. More worrying, though. Could be a blow for the World Cup. He had kicked around for around about 8 weeks. Towards the overhead again. Save from Carpita. There's a worry for Italy. I don't think we'll see him again tonight. Carpita with the shots. Just over. The goalkeeper had it well covered. Often consider beach soccer a bit like basketball in the final period is where a lot of the action happens. This middle section here can be a little bit of a lull, eye of the storm if you like. Players get tired, mistakes creep in. Oh, that is absolutely perfect. Well, the volley, crisp as you like. Sat perfectly, struck through the ball. Cia Martani, second goal in this tournament, his debut tournament for Italy. He's got that look of a man who does it all the time. And he's smiling now, yeah. Trying to play it cool before. Duca will be pleased. Round two. Italy 2. Starting to get a little bit more pace into it this period. Nice handball. Not given. Well, get out of jail free card for Italy. Maybe an accidental, but it's still handball. Of course, the handball room now has been overly complicated, but that's pretty simple. Hit his arm, be kicking the referee who's right behind it and just waved it away. Interesting to know his opinion. Did he wave it away because it was accidental? He knew it hit the arm, or did he wave it away because he didn't see it? Peter. Cirillo was crying out as he went for that ball. He knew he wasn't going to get there. World Cup 2017, was Italy victorious 5-4. It's the last time these two sides met. Obviously, they don't see each other too often because one is in the European Confederation and the other in the Asian. Real international tournaments we get are the World Cup, the Intercontinental Cup in Dubai, and now this, World Beach Games, inaugural event. Was originally meant to be in San Diego. Just moved to Qatar with just 4 months' notice, and I'd say it's been a real success. Big crowds every night, barring now. Big crowds, especially the beach soccer. The venue itself has got lots of sports here at Qatar. It's just been buzzing every single night. Qatar could do with a little bit of good publicity after the World Athletics Championship. Everybody was complaining there was no crowds there. Of course, controversy always reigns over 2022. Any chance anyone has to have a complaint about it, they will do. Qatar can only do what it does. Quietly get on with getting the facilities ready and hosting events like this in the run-up to prove that they can do it. Bari sees the yellow card. Oh, it's a great strike by Zirlo. Bar saves it around. Saniti dispossessed, luckily enough for Italy. Iran just give them the ball straight back. So there we have it, end of the second period. Here's the tale of two periods. First one, Iran, two goals to the good. Second period, Italy plugging away, eventually close the gap. So we go into the break level. There's that foul on Zirlo. Means little now because it's the end of the period. And it sees Iran 2, Italy 2. Beach soccer, a little different from other sports, other forms of football anyway. Once we have 3/3, we have to toss the coin in the final period. And Italy have won that toss and they've elected to kick off. Why wouldn't you? Members of Team USA there, there's 97 nations here at the ANOC World Beach Games. Sports as diverse as bouldering. You kind of imagine, don't you, like Indiana Jones, someone running down a tunnel with a boulder after them. Not quite like that. It's actually climbing on the, like the indoor wall type thing you'll see, but outdoor here. I've not explained it very clearly. That's why I'm commentating on beach soccer and not bouldering. Oh, what a strike! And guess who? Gori. From any angle, from any distance, that man can score. And he can score a spectacular. And he's done just that. Well, I said I thought he was out of the game when he limped off. He scored in the last period. We thought that was it from him. Miraculous recovery. Bit of cold spray, bit of ice. Bang! That's what he can do. maybe a question or two over Hamid there. Maybe a step or two to his left would have been better. But it's all easy in slow motion, isn't it? Gori. Second goal for him. 13 for the tournament. Well, normally in the European Soccer League, they have trophies for the highest goal scorer. We are not doing them here at this event, so Gori will get nothing for his efforts. Maybe we can do him a certificate or something like that. He deserves it. And a Chiotti. Well, we as media staff actually got a certificate each, so if we can get one, surely Gori's worth one. Chiotti fouled. A nice distance. I think he'll go for power here. Two choices for players in this distance. You bounce it in front of the goalkeeper. Ideally 2-3 metres in front of him, so the divot will take it up and into the goal, or you go for sheer power. And Amichiotti, as the player he is, and the distance he's running up, I think we can safely say he's going for power. Sets himself. Step to his left. He's run up just about perfect. Will the shot be? Oh, it certainly will! Fantastic strike. Well, he just had the look of confidence, didn't he? The man who was going to score as soon as he got that free kick. As soon as he set the ball, he knew how far he had to run for his maximum power. And he certainly got a light in the shot. Perfect technique. Think about that power and then think about striking a ball in your bare feet. It takes some special technique. Mokhtari. Our announcer there. Always he's rather excited when the ball goes wide. Can hear. Sat behind me, slightly worrying to be fair. I don't know, with his shot. Oh! Well, how didn't that go in? Seemed to bounce off the sand and I just took it wide. There was the divot that saved Iran in that case. And when we looked at the first period, Italy just 3 shots on target. At the end of the second period, it was 9. 25 shots in all, compared to just 6 in the first period. The difference is plain to see. Iran, 6 on target, 14 shots in the first period in total. At the end of the second, 10 and 19. That's 20. And not on target. Stats in beach soccer are definitely not rocket science. It's pretty simple, isn't it? The more shots you have, the better your chance of winning. Tari. Oh, wow. Just shot perfectly for the captain. Del Messi, despondent in goal. Do they deserve that, Iran, regardless of which they've got it? Well, the easiest goal the captain will score in his career. Ahmedzadi. Mokhtari it was with the overhead kick. Despairing dive from Del Mestri. Some happy Iranian fans on the drums there. Break. Well, that's lifted them that goal. A little bit of more pace about them now. I'm at you. captain's clash. Clearance is extremely long. Crowdy on the ball. Oh, he's got those shorts pulled up. Like an 80s footballer. Crowdy's got space and time. Will he go for the overhead? He will. Zillo. Well, if he was in a cartoon world, there'd be Tweety Birds flying around his head right now. Okay, went down in slow motion after that hit him. That ball is lighter, about 200 grams lighter than a normal football. It still hurts when it comes to you at that pace. Of course, you get the sand in your eyes and everything else. The amount of power generated in overhead kick is pretty unbelievable at this level. Here it is, time for the two coaches. Average number of goals in a beach soccer game is about 9. Got a couple more goals in this game. One goal lead is absolutely nothing at this level. There's a lot of time left. Even if you had a 3-goal lead, he can still be whittled away. Mestri. Oxen goes long. Not much you need to be further forward, realistically, to do anything with that ball. Now stuck in the corner in a cloud of sand. Does well to get out of that position. Gets the corner. Well, that is the second prize because the shot was going goalwards, but he did really well to get anything from that position. Well, it's for a second. Well, there's a penalty. I thought for a second the referee was going to give it the other way. Took his time running to the centre spot. Frianetti, a free shot at goal. Yes, he's pushed him, shall we say. It looks worse from that angle. So, I think that is the correct decision. Frianetti was looking for it. Ahmed checks his posts. Okay. Wishes they were a bit closer together, I'm sure. Frianetti. Oh, easy as you like, into the side netting. Italy restore that 2-goal cushion. Smiles all round, hugs all round as well. Stuttered his run ever so slightly, let the goalkeeper go one way. Place the ball in the opposite corner. So it's a scream of delight. To his teammates, including Gori. So round 3, Italy 5. Go left. Should we go right? Go left.
How you doing? It's great to have you and the rest of the Chief and Spider
tonight. Buddy.
Also joined here at the Beach Locker where I have a party who is having a good time. As well as all the thousands in attendance right here at Beach Locker Arena.
So that was really well there tonight for a match. He was calm play. looked like getting lost in a cloud of dust on that left hand side, Palmacci. But he takes the throw. Overhead, well wide. Well, you get the feeling that some of these Italian players maybe, Gordon hits over them, reaching the twilight of their career. I've heard rumours that certain players are going to retire after the World Cup. Whether some of these Italian players will be that, like Del Messi, the goalkeeper, is 36 now. Brissaniti, 36 also. And one player that Italy don't have, the gap in their squad, is Josep Jr. Apparently missed the flight and he's been outstanding in the Euro Beach Soccer League this year. Brazilian by birth. Maybe he would have given them the edge that could have taken them to the final. Of course, that's a big, big ask against Brazil. Well, he is off. Shit. Can't get it past the wall of blue shirts. Well, Italy are doing what they do really well. That's breaking up the play and just slowing things down, making it difficult for their opponents. Technically, you can't waste time. You can't waste too much time in beach soccer because if the keeper has the ball, you have a throw or a corner, you've got 5 seconds to take it. But with free kicks and the like, you can't break the play up. Marinai will definitely fancy this one. I think he'll put some power into it. My position is just behind him. He's got a great view of the goal. There's the strike, the bounce. As the announcer said, yeah, it was a lucky bounce. Lucky for Iran as it went over the bar. But he hit that perfect type of free kick from that distance where you bounce it in front of the goalkeeper. 2 meters. Attari demands the referee, gives a penalty. He's not given up. Iran win the ball back. Ali over to the far side. Not exactly what he meant to do, I'm sure. That's why that wasn't given. Play continues. The winning coach had been spoken to. Roundly ignoring the referee.
Okay, we're now approaching the last couple of minutes of the game. Over here, fans, get it loud. Come on, everybody, clap your hands.
Don't hurry. He said he'd go for it from any angle. Quite in tune with what he was thinking. Eventually, Iran get the throw. Tari again. That's the free kick. You can't interfere with the player going for the overhead kick. Zubar did that with a header. That's a bit of a mute point, that. At what point are they going for the overhead kick? There's little doubt there he was, but if you, the ball is flicked up and you headed it, before they'd started rotating. Then you've got every chance he won't concede the free kick. Gervaro's experienced enough to know better. It's interesting now as you watch Del Mestri go off, Capita come in. Italy do this because the player taking a free kick will be expecting a certain keeper and will look at his weaknesses and maybe pick out the spot that is weakest on him. By flipping the goalkeeper, Italy thinks this makes a difference. It puts the player off, it makes him nervous. Let's see if that is the case. Mokhtari. 7 goals so far in the tournament. Oh, well, it did work. Well, that's what the coach would be telling us anyway. Got Peter with the save. Looked down really well to his right-hand side. Pericinetti just looks around, sees the free kick is given. A little doubt that was a free kick, and he could say, yeah, yellow. I would say so. Well, this is interesting because he went down, rolled around a bit, so he got the free kick, saw there was no yellow card, got up, said, that's not right. But he has hurt himself there, he's cut himself. Giving the benefit of the doubt. Yellow card. Second one for Iran in this game. She looks to be enjoying it. Replacement goalkeeper. They normally flip the goalkeeper back straight away afterwards, but Carpita has stayed between the sticks. Del Duca. I think they can see this as a success, getting the bronze medal. Excellent preparation for the World Cup. Sheer turn and shot, pounced on by Carpita. Emiliano Del Duca urging calm. Chiani gets the free kick. Now Italy will only swap a goalkeeper for these free kicks when it's from a certain distance. That's too far away to consider swapping a keeper. Oh, very complex. Prayer or two, and a chance for himself to get him focused. Carney with the shots. Oh, and here's a good finish. Maybe a question or two about Carpita. But he caught it with such venom. He had such dip on it. Seemed to put the goalkeeper off. Got his hands to it, the goalkeeper. As we would say in Liverpool, where I'm from, your hands like crisp packets. Coach completely emotionless there. I'm sure they're churning up inside him. So is it round 4, Italy 5, Zirlo! Oh, they would have loved him to have scored that one. Just immediately eased the pressure. If we go 2 extra time, then it will be 3 minutes. And after that, penalties. 3 penalties each. Peter, grateful that was straight to him. Gordy. just outside the area. Or is it the penalty? It is the penalty inside the area. Well, this is getting extremely interesting now. Yellow card issued. The man who scored the free kick. Well, there was a handball at the other end that wasn't given. That one has been given. There you go, Italy have switched their goalkeeper, as we mentioned. Can be the choice of the team who takes the penalty. Gianni is the choice. And scores! Underneath Almestri. Iran a level. We've got 93 seconds left. You would say harsh for the penalty. And he was not going to show any sympathy to Italy. No chance for Dalmestri. Happy Iranian fans. Is there a winner? In normal time. Bronze medal at stake. The ANOC World Beach Games. The inaugural edition, as you can tell from the crowds here. Very successful beach soccer tournament. Oh, Dalmestri punches it over the bar. He was unsighted. Sami hit it. It was almost straight at him. We had to get two hands to it. Barley being awkward. Now the two tallest players on the pitch are almost taking part in their own personal beach wrestling competition. Piatti needs to be careful. He's careful enough. Gore! Oh, well, that's good defensive work. Just. Could have been an own goal. Well, we've got two balls on the pitch now. We need to get rid of one.
Okay, super fans in the house, who do you think is going to win here? Is it Italy or is it Iran?
Julian Akbari. You see him facing away from the goal. That didn't work. It's a goal now, surely it's the winner. Inches away. Gordy now. Oh, what a save that is. Instinctive goalkeeping. Reached up a right hand there. Stopped Gordy's overhead kick. Would have been a trademark finish for Italy if it happened. It didn't. But they have the corner. Gordy. He's spoken to by the referee. And Manchi is waiting patiently on the corner. Particularly worth the wait. Easy for Dalmestri. He's made it look good with a dive. Attention, music's playing. Not much being said by the crowd here. Oh, Ranocchiotti, he's just been further to the far post. His size, he would have gotten the end of that. Gordy, ambitious to say the least. And we reach the end of normal time with it all square. And there's that save 15 seconds to go. Has that made all the difference? Getting the coach completely emotionless. Confirmation of your scoreline. Let's get it to them, Frode. At 1 point, both teams 2 goals up on their opponents. They managed to claw it back. First period was a tale of Iran, 2-0 up. Italy back to 2-2 in the second period. And all the action in the third. We go to extra time, which will be 3 minutes. Don Mesty with the save. Extremely good save. If it's still tied after 3 minutes, we go to penalties, 3 each. And if that's still tied, we then go to sudden death. Hamid. Hamid again. Fancy the shot. He's done it a couple of times already in this match. Atsui. Over the top. I feel I should be whispering here. The tension builds. They're playing the tension music in the stadium. Got it. Can't get on the end of it. He can get a throw in though. Eventually when he gets the ball, Del Duca. He's an experienced coach. He's won international trophies. He's won domestic trophies. He would desperately love a bronze medal right now. Well, that was an initial handball, I think. And then second handball. You need a replay of that to fully work it out. So let's have a look. Yeah, Gatti's handball first. And then as they appeal, the second handball comes in. If I wait for it. Well, it was a handball by Nalcati just first. You can complain all you like, but it's not going to change the fact, is it? I'm not sure what went on there. Sportsmanship, we get given a free kick, take the free kick. I think he kind of changed his mind there. Couldn't decide what to do, but one handball is the one that's first. Obviously, you can't have two handballs when you pass each other out. Mestri deals with it well. Gordy. All he can get is a second prize of a corner from Kearney. 2-goal scorer in the last period. All the way out. Giovaro really couldn't get hold of it. Well, he needs to stop doing this. Italy, just get up, throw the ball, let's try and get a goal. Into the final minute of extra time. Had it covered all the way. It wasn't a bad effort though by Domestic. Hamid. Let's try the shot. Go to his right instead. Atsui. Save again by Domestic. His third good save in this extra time period. Atsumi versus Domestri. Didn't test Domestri. Another wasted that free kick. Probably just heard inside the last 30 seconds. And Chiotti.
Here we go, last 12 seconds. 10.
That's the one last chance for Iran. They've got to go forward quickly. He's got to do it quickly. He has, but he's wide. And there is Fajuta for the end of extra time. We now go to sudden death. The penalty shootout. Football's equivalent of Russian roulette. Penalty shootout will work like this, best of three. You can have all your players on the sand and choose whoever you like. You can switch goalkeepers during a penalty shootout as well if you wish. And it's equal after three penalties, then we go to sudden death, and then we rotate around the team until we go around everybody. It's Italy with a smaller squad than Iran. So the penalty shootout is going to be in the left-hand goal. Two more games to go in the big soccer stadium today. Gold medal match.
Let's go, everybody!
Between Spain and Great Britain in the women's event.
And the last game of beach soccer. Let's hear it out. All out energy.
And Russia. Up against Brazil in the men's event. Final day of the ANL World Beach Games. That's the medals being decided today. Moving that to beach soccer. So decisions made to go to the right. Del Mestre will stay in goal. Brazil fan getting in nice and early. As you would expect, all players arm in arm on the halfway line. Our first penalty taker gets ready. Hopefully a captain's penalty from the captain. Pentardi. 6 World Cups. Apparently, after the game tonight, he will go to bed in the shirt that he's wearing now. Any tournament, the last time he plays, he wears the shirt in bed. I think that's going to be a bit sweaty. He's going to be wearing that in bed, celebratory style. Well, he can get his team on the way with this penalty. He certainly does. Perfectly done into the side netting. Calmly done. Don't mess with it the right way, but no chance. So it is Iran 1, Italy 0. Chiavaro stepping up for Italy, and they switch their goalkeeper to Hosseini. MVP in the last World Cup in terms of goalkeepers. And the goal of the World Cup, would you believe? He wants to stop goals right now. Giovanni. Misses! Well, a master stroke to Hosseini in goal. So quick down to his right. Del Duca can't quite believe it. Mentally going to switch their goalkeeper. Carpita. Almost he faced the first penalty, Carpita the second. Bari. Previously won most valuable player in Asian Games in 2016. May prove himself valuable now. He can, it's the same side as the previous penalty, no chance for Carpita. And Iran lead 2-0, 100% record on their penalties. Got the benefit of having one penalty shootout in this tournament already against Senegal, which they won. They're well practiced under pressure situations. Gori, Italy's all-time record goal scorer, 13 goals in this tournament. Surely he can't miss. Say that in quotation marks. Gori scores. Well, that's a popular side of the goal for players at the moment. Iran lead 2-1. Final penalty. Iran score, Italy miss. Well, Iran score and Italy score. And Iran have won. Good free kick, our penalty in the game. Scores this. Bronze is for Iran. Steps up. That scores! Iran have the bronze medal. It's not gold, it's not silver. But it certainly feels good, and to do it on a penalty shootout feels that little bit better. Just open his body out into the far side. Del Messi went the wrong way. There were such confident penalties from Iran. He switched up their goalkeeper for the penalty shootout. Hosseini went in goal. He saved the first penalty from Italy. And that made the difference. And finally, we get some emotion from the Iranian bench. And they're not going to the World Cup. But there's some consolation here at the AINOC World Beach Games. Third position is no mean feat, especially when you beat the likes of Italy in the playoff final. Hamid. Played the most minutes on the pitch out of the two goalkeepers, have been excellent throughout. Well, in the field has been brilliant for them as well. There's confirmation of your scoreline. 5-5 in normal time. Iran win 3-1 on penalties.